Nothing has changed. Those words, infamous from the dementia tax U-turn during last year's general election, are being used by many people today to describe yesterday's reshuffle, perhaps because it wasn't the radical overhaul they'd expected, perhaps because of reports that some cabinet ministers, such as Jeremy Hunt, refused to move. But actually, quite a bit did change. 31% of cabinet attendees are new to their role. And in some cases, there's been too much change. The new Justice Secretary, David Gawk, is the sixth person to hold that position since 2010. The new Work and Pensions Secretary, Esther McVeigh, is the fifth to hold her position since 2015. Changing ministers too frequently is a bad thing. You've just built up specialist expertise, you've got to grip to your department, and then whoosh, you're off somewhere else. And all of this at a time when the Ministry of Justice faces big challenges like a crisis in prisons, and the Department for Work and Pensions, the biggest department by staff numbers and by budget, is still rolling out universal credit. One thing that might look like a change is the apparent creation of two new departments, the Ministry of Housing, Communities and Local Government, and the Department of Health and Social Care. Actually, for the former, nothing has changed. It was already responsible for housing, and its only new responsibility will be changing the nameplates and the stationery. And the Department of Health already had a lot of responsibilities for social care. We're still waiting to see if anything else has been transferred into it.
Cool.
The gender balance has changed. 35% of cabinet attendees are now women, up from 30% before. But the shine was taken off that fact by yesterday's highest profile departure being a woman, Education Secretary Justine Greening. There was also no announcement about her successor as the Minister for Women and Equalities. Yesterday's reshuffle has been branded shambolic by most of the newspapers today, partly because of Greening's exit, partly because of some ministers refusing to budge, partly because of Chris Grayling's misannouncement as new Tory party chairman, and the general sense that it was a bit underwhelming. But again, the narrative is that one of the most powerful weapons in the Prime Minister's arsenal, a reshuffle, has misfired, reflecting a loss of political authority since the early general election. In that sense, at least, nothing has changed.